Hey, it's Rich back with you for another video. Standing here with the Waco and Martin, who just...
Hey.
Well, how long has it been since you bought this airplane? It's been a few months at least.
No, I think it's probably been 10 months now since I bought it.
Yeah, so finally getting the opportunity to fly it back to Martin's home near Vancouver. We're taking it all the way from Long Beach. It's about 900 plus nautical miles. We kind of wanted to travel up the coast, but because of the weather, we're going to go inland. And we got some weather to deal with coming out of here. We got a TFR today, so it's a little more complicated flight, but it's kind of a bittersweet one for me because I'm going to miss this airplane. But I'm really happy. Martin and I got to do some flying in the Waco a month ago, and I'm very happy he's getting the airplane. It's going to be a lot of fun. And you've been looking at this airplane.
Got some good training, for sure.
Yeah, and you've been looking at this airplane for a while, right?
It's probably the last 40 years.
So that's really cool because, you know, Waco's a special airplane, and it takes a special person to really want the airplane. So we're excited to take you guys along for the ride and tell you more about Martin's experience flying and how we got to this point, and looking forward to the flight.
One of the problems we have on the coast is it's been cloudy. And not just cloudy, but low.
Yeah. Marginal VFR.
Not even marginal VFR, like 400 overcast where you can't even get in there. And then you have, you know, you have terrain. Mm-hmm. And so it's you may have
to be 7,000 feet here.
Yeah, we may have to be in the Central Valley.
I guess the weather sort of stops, like the
policeman. Yeah, it could be right here.
Unless there's an inversion or something.
So we'll just kind of have to play it by ear and see what, and typically the afternoons.
Lots of places to land up here, too.
Yeah, and this isn't a bad... I mean, this is just farmland with the Sierras off to the east. It's not bad.
You might even be able to hug up here.
Yeah, exactly. This is these foothills are really pretty. But the thing is, if you draw a straight line, which is what I was going to do on this one... So see how far off the coast?
Oh, yeah.
So going the coast is...
Is a longer route.
Is a longer route. Mm. But in my view, it's worth it. Because it's beautiful. And if you've never done it, what other chance you can have to do it? See, hugging this the western slope of the Sierras would be nice too. But you see the valley kind of goes up through there.
I stopped drinking coffee.
Oh, did you?
Man, it's killing me too. But I feel a lot better.
Do you? So what's it telling you for a flight time? I mean, I've sort of gauged it to be about 10 hours of flight time. I think it's like 950 nautical miles.
9 hours and 16 minutes.
Yeah.
And it's 900 miles, so it's 100 knots, figuring 100 knots.
Yeah. But I'd have 2 cups in the morning.
Easy 2 cups for me. Probably more like, literally probably more like 4 cups before 10 o'clock.
Wow.
What's really cool is if we could come up the coast, you know, you got... San Francisco, and you can fly the Golden Gate Bridge. You can literally, and that'd be beautiful if the weather's good. You can literally fly right over at VFR and come up over this and come underneath the Bravo here. It's really pretty. But in the Waco, you know, you don't have the option to say, well, let's go check the coast out, because it's going to take so long to go back the other way.
Yeah.
And the way they process the beans.
Well, what are the tasks saying for tomorrow? For example,
unfortunately, low clouds.
Everything, all the way up.
Yeah. So if you look at I love sweets. I love cookies and milkshakes.
Yeah.
But I never have, I don't wake up thinking about I want a milkshake or a cookie.
Yeah.
But when you wake up, when you're addicted to coffee, it's like. It's almost like you gotta have that. These will typically are VFR, but let's look at what was Nevada? Where was Nevada County? Was
from Modesto?
Things aren't gonna go right unless you have that cup of coffee.
You must miss it though. You must just miss that. I really like it.
I do. I really like coffee. Let's look at Calaveras County. What's that?
CPU.
CPU. See, it's VFR now. VFR, VFR, VFR. You see? So that's all clear.
Well, I think that's what we got to do.
Yeah. But we can, the good thing is we can take off and head north and, you know, be at an altitude where we can look and see, and if it's socked in to the left, we'll just turn to the right a little bit and head for like Nevada County.
I think it's going to be great either way, man. It'll be super
sweet. I mean, that's a beautiful, don't get me wrong, this, there's nothing to frown at here. This is beautiful, too.
Well, you know, I live on the coast. I'm going to get a lot of coastal footage. This is something I've never seen or done this Sierra Nevada.
It's cool.
I mean, I've had through periods of having cream, but I'm not picky. I don't need lattes and just like a cup of coffee.
Or so you're saying we'd leave, where's Long Beach? Long Beach is here.
Something like that, right? Mm-hmm. Like, so I head to this VOR kind of thing?
We gotta go because of the TFR. Mm.
It sounds like a lot of stuff's just pointing us to go that way, isn't it?
Yeah. So what we have to do is get out of the TFR. Well, if we go IFR, we can just go pretty much, probably go out here and around. And then once we clear the TFR, we cancel. And we'll just fly up. And see, the direct route puts us on that anyway, right in the foothills. Now we just turn here instead of going direct.
I almost wish I wouldn't have felt any different, because then I sort of would have been like, play by ear.
Yeah, a couple buddies that are like, why'd you buy a lock? Why'd you buy my plane? Why'd you buy a lock? I'm like, I can't explain it, dude. Yeah. This is all I've ever wanted.
What you get out of that plane, to me, is different. It's a whole different. It's not transportation. It's a whole different.
It's the golden age.
Value.
It's a golden age. Yeah. And I think there back. Is a...
In 1930s, if you got in a Waco, it'd be the equivalent of getting into like a Gulfstream.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you were somebody if you're traveling in a Waco by air.
Yeah.
You know, that says something. And think about it, you gotta get bundled up. It's cold, it's windy, it's loud.
Yeah.
No Bose headsets.
No.
But still, you're somebody.
Yeah.
This picture. This says something. That's Clyde Cessna. That's what his original airplane, Silver Wings, right? Look at Clyde. Look at his pants. I mean, he's all greasy. But look at the people that have come to see him. They're driving cars. They got ties and hats and suits.
Oh,
look
it's
at the
a
kids.
Spectacle, right?
You see, it's a spectacle.
And they're wealthy people.
To watch this farmer, you know, take this airplane and potentially kill himself. And they're coming out in their cars and they're all dressed up. And that, to me, you know, think that sets the stage for, and this has been the 1920s. Mm-hmm. And it's just this guy, you know, it's just this farmer that threw together this airplane and nobody taught him to fly. Maybe. Look at it. Just look at him.
Yeah.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah, super cool.
This is what's amazing to me. Clyde Cessna Bank, you know, he was a tinkerer, farmer. He wasn't a businessman. He bankrupted Cessna Aircraft Company. And his nephew, Dwayne Wallace, took it out of bankruptcy. Okay. He was an engineer and a businessman.
Yeah.
And he revived it.
Yeah.
But he kept Cessna's name.
Yeah.
A lot of people, I mean, a lot of people say it should be called the Wallace Aircraft Company because he's the one that really made it a commercially viable company.
But as a homage to his uncle,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. That's the kind of guy he was. He was a real good guy. Okay, so our route is going to be to some
degree. And then what do you think, fly 2 hours at a stretch?
Yeah. However we feel.
Okay. This is the fabulous little John, portable urinal.
It's going to be tough in a Waco.
You'd have to unbuckle it.
I got mine, too. In the front seat, it'd be a lot easier. The Waco, you're better off landing.
Here's to now. Here's to now. Actually, was thinking, said everything. Cause Epcot seats get awesome that we don't worry about sitting on your doorstep waiting for you to come home or come out. Well, Epcot seats have a sound tonight that we don't care about. So here's to now. Here's to now.
after ending up our two-day mission here from Long Beach. It's been a really cool flight. I mean, it's been amazing. That flight over the Bay Area, that was one of the coolest flights I think I've ever been on.
Yeah.
Hopefully we got some good video. We don't know yet because we haven't seen it, but hopefully you saw it already as we're talking. And as I mentioned in the intro, this is kind of a bittersweet time for me because I'm saying goodbye to this airplane. But me and Mark are going to be buddies now, so I know I'm going to come up here and hang out with him and fly the airplane again, so I feel good about that. What do you got? Any last thoughts from you, Mark?
I'm just after watching all your videos, I'm happy to be finally flying with Rich.
That's right. Good deal. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.
Well, here we are. You probably can't really see us that well, but we made it all the way to Vancouver, I think.
Long Beach, it was about 1,000 miles all the way.
I think we flew for about 12 hours and we saw some amazing stuff. And here's the Waco home at the Victoria Flying Club in Victoria, BC.
And I'm really happy for Martin, but I'm a little sad, I have to say, a little sad to say goodbye to this airplane, but I'll be back.
Yeah.
I'll be back. And it's really love it here, too. What a great airport, man. Beautiful.
It's really dark out, so we apologize for the very pixelated video.
But what a fun flight.
Peace.
See ya.